Let's see how we can publish other security groups to Configuration Hub. So in order to publish or create security group, I'll first go to security groups here. I can go to create a new security group. Let's create as SysManager 1. So I give OK. I brought up with this screen. So I'll assign this SysManager role because that is what I want for this security group. And I'll assign all the resources to this security group and go back to General tab and confirm on the rank of this user, this security group. We can see it is rank 1. So I'll give apply and I give OK. So we can see here the config sec group, that is the by default node level security group, has a role 0, rank 0, and the new security groups that we create are having rank 1. So now what we'll try to do is, since we have created this security group, it will automatically get published to Privacy Authentication. So we can confirm this by going to Configuration Hub. Inside security in groups, we can look for SCADA, and we can see here we have the SysMGR1 group published here. Now what we want to do is we want to assign this security group to this ch_admin user. So we have the ch_admin default user. We want to have it to have the new security group as well. So we go into group membership here. We search for our Simplicity group that we just published. This is the one. We'll assign this to this user. Now let's go back to our Simplicity and see how we can control or how we can utilize these security groups now. So if I come back here and look at the SysManager privileges, we can see that he's having the process control privilege. So what we'll do, we'll remove this process control privilege for this user, okay? And we'll try to do a login with that user here. So I'll start the project. Our project has started now. Now we know by looking at a configuration hub here, we know that ch_admin has the both scopes, the node level scope, that is config sec group, and we have also assigned SysMGR1 to that user. So what rank would have priority? So we have given rank 1 to SysMGR1. That means that when we try to log in to kind of this Simplicity, that ch_admin user would be assigned a SysMGR1 role. So let's try to confirm that. So let's go to process control and let's log in with the same user. So you're logged in with the SysMGR1 ch_admin user only, but we can see that we are brought up with this window that tells that you do not have privilege to perform process control. So why did that happen? So if you look at the roles here, config has process control, right? And SysManager doesn't have process control. So if you look at the users here in security groups, SysMGR1 is the higher ranked security group. So the ch_admin user that gets logged into Simplicity is assigned this security group, SysMGR1. And based on Sys security group, he is assigned SysMGR role. And since the SysMGR role doesn't have the process control, we were displayed with this error that you do not have the process control privilege. So in order to solve that, we'll do the same thing. We'll just update the privileges for this SysManager role and we'll try to log in again. So if I go back to SysManager and I give the process control privilege to this user, this role, and I give OK, I do a config update to make those changes available and I'll start the project again. I go back to process control and try to log in here. We are giving the same credentials again, so that it is still the same user only, but we have updated this SysManager role with the new privilege. So upon login, we can see we are able to have the complete control on all these processes now. We'll exit, and that is how we use security groups to restrict privileges and configuration abilities for different users that exist on Configuration Hub.